This is Field Communications in Chicago.
The most incredible history of World War II ever filmed, told by those who lived and fought through it, and narrated by Laurence Olivier. The World at War. Sunday night at 6 on Channel 32 WFLD-TV Chicago.
Tonight, 30 minutes of very remarkable entertainment coming to you almost live with your host for tonight, Mr. Barth Kimball. Tonight, Barth's guest will be Mr. Vern Taylor, sucking his trumpet for a good cause. Candy Lee Hargrove, tapped out and tapping for a good cause. Frankie Kid Carbone, punched out and punchy just because it's a good cause. And Happy Kyne and the Mirthmaker. And me, I'm Jerry Hubbard. And now here's your host and mine, Mr. Barth Kimball.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Good evening and welcome again to Fernwood Tonight. I'm Barth Kimball, and no, our entire backdrop and furnishings have not been looted because of a blackout. I'll tell you what happened. That business with my past life in Miami finally hit the fan. And it all came to a head last night when yours truly was cleverly served on this show with a singing and dancing subpoena. Here's our Jerry Hubbard, our co-host.
That was a great moment last night. This is awful. I've been here at this station 6 years. I've never seen anything like this.
Well, it's embarrassing. Yeah. Okay. Now, several weeks ago, incidentally, my attorney, and it's okay for lawyers to advertise now, so I can tell you his name is Andrew DeLug, and he's a fine attorney. Divorce has started at $250, and wills, he'll go as low as $35 to start. Anyway, he found out that if I pleaded guilty, that Miami charges could be disposed of with just a fine, and that they would reduce the charge of assaulting the cheerleader to a misdemeanor mayhem, and the payola charge to misdemeanor receiving stolen property, if I pleaded guilty. Now, believe me, nothing goes more deeply against the gimbal grain than guilt of any kind. I think you know that, Jerry. But it's better to get these things over with, so we decided reluctantly to pay that cash fine. To do that, we hocked all the great furniture on the set. That I had purchased, incidentally, for this show. And you should know that this is a Barth Kimball policy, by the way, to own all the furnishings and appointments of the show, lock, stock, and hassock. And even Johnny Carson doesn't have that in his contract. You know that. Anyway, I had to hock it all to keep me here so you could get the entertainment that you deserve. Because I know you folks don't tune in to see sofas and drapes. So, the fine is paid.
Are you going to be going on for a while? Because I got a quarter here. I'm going to step out and get a Pepsi. If you have another 15 cents, I'll bring you back one, too.
No, Jerry, I don't care for a Pepsi, all right?
Well, I just thought I'd bring two. It'd be easy to bring two. Do you have a dime? Because I'll pick up a nickel out here.
Jerry, I don't want a Pepsi. I'm not thirsty.
Okay, I'll just step out.
Okay. Anyway, I must say I feel better about not clogging up our courts with this whole petty business, especially at a time when rapists are walking the streets and in some cases even driving. We're here, we're going to stay here, and we're going to rebuild. That's the kind of people we are, and I mean that sincerely. Tonight, some of our very, very good friends will contribute their talents to help raise the money necessary to buy back my furniture. It's basically, I guess, a telethon. Really, to help a television show that's been crippled. And no, I'm not ashamed to use that word. Attacked by that savage crippler of young television shows. The Miami Supreme Court. Anyway, your nickels and dimes and possibly hundreds of dollars can help. The phone lines are open. The number to call is 555-5624. That's 555-5624. Oh, boy, Jerry, could I use some of that? Oh, boy. This isn't even the diet kind, but it's good anyway. Oh, boy.
No, keep it. I'll get another.
Do you have enough money?
No.
We'll share it.
All right.
Okay.
I'll set it over here. Yeah. I should have brought another cup.
Anyway, while you're phoning in your pledges to make our program healthy... Oh, that's good. And make it whole once again. Here's our first entertainer of the evening. I'll tell you something, honestly, I don't even know what order we're going in tonight. Usually, I spend a couple hours a day, going over the paper trying to find guests. But I have no idea what order they're coming out here or anything, so it's been a crazy day. Here's our first guest. Come on out and sign in, please.
Thank you, boss. On the way out here, I took the liberty of putting a dollar in the kitty.
Oh, that's very nice. Usually we just... a little bit of milk and some tuna is all we give her. I'm sorry. It's just a little joke. I don't mean to make... I don't know. It's just my way of keeping from crying.
You know, I said I took liberty. And taking liberty, it seems to me, is what this program is all about. Bob Gimmel here understands that freedom is like a muscle. If you don't constantly exercise it, it gets soft and flabby and hurts like the devil the next time you use it. Unless you put on some absorbing junior. Now, sure, America has some soft spots. Maybe this country needs a few push-ups and one of those waist belts that makes you sweat. But it's still the only country where you can spout what you feel like spouting because we have a constitution. Well, that doesn't mean that those half-soaked liberals can stand up and spout dumb things like impeach the president, save our whales. Do you have a warrant? That's not free speech. That's free garbage. And that's where a host like Barth Gimbel comes in. Without a host, this show would be a bunch of people all talking at once. And at least of them would try to sneak in and impeach the president. So you get stuff like the Ruskies are dealing out because they don't even have a president. And even if they did, it would take two or three of them to do what Nixon did. And then they'd be digging into your pockets to help Barth Gimbel get this show back on the loafers. Or on the other hand, living in Russia, where they probably only have one channel and it's a foreign language to boot. This American knows what way to butter his muffin. Goes by paraphrasing the words of the coach, the late Green Bay Packers, Mr. Vince Lombardi. Getting Bart furniture back isn't everything, and it isn't the only thing, but he needs it. Next up, I'd like to dedicate a number to those viewers who may be dozing off in a ploy to not to contribute to our great cause here. A little favorite of mine is a wake-up number, as a matter of fact. I've got it, Hap.
If you suffer pain or itch of hemorrhoidal tissues, use Preparation H for hours of comfort in many cases. When occasional pain, itch, and swelling of hemorrhoidal tissues occur, Preparation H gives prompt temporary relief in many cases. Then Preparation H goes beyond soothing, actually helps shrink swelling of hemorrhoidal tissues due to inflammation. For temporary relief of hemorrhoid symptoms, get doctor-tested Preparation H. Goes beyond soothing, helps shrink swelling of hemorrhoidal tissues.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog.
It's Elvis Presley. Yes, at last, here's the great hits made famous by the king, Elvis. Combined for the first time on these two incredible RCA albums and available only by mail through this special offer. You get Don't Be Cruel.
Don't Be Cruel.
Remember the beautiful Love Me Tender?
Love Me Tender.
And of course, Jailhouse Rock.
You should have had to knock that jailbird.
Return to Sender. All Shook Up. Teddy Bear. And the beautiful...
But I...
If you send now, you'll get all these hits and so many more. Elvis, his great hits, two fantastic RCA albums, yours for the amazing low price of just $7.98. Only by mail. Send for yours now.
To order this final tribute to Elvis, call toll-free 800-327-1010, 800-327-1010, or save COD fees and just $7.98 for records, $9.98 for tape to Hound Dog, Box 3546, Chicago, Illinois. That's Hound Dog, Box 3546, Chicago, Illinois. Supplies limited. Call now, 800-327-1010.
For Norman Lear's newest comedy, Look at Us.
Well, you know how I feel about perversion, honey. It can be very intriguing under the right circumstances.
Hello. Daddy, are you in there?
Oh, this suspense is killing me.
Forever Fernwood premieres Monday night at 10 on Channel 32.
Thanks, Abby. Vern, I'm sorry. It's just rigged that way. You can't call out, but if you really do need to, you can use the one down the hall. Okay?
Oh, I'm at the ready.
All right, you just stay there. And if it gets real important, we'll have someone call for you. Okay. Well, as your calls come pouring in, Jerry will be right here doing the tallying on our WZAZ tote board. Why don't you explain how this works, Jerry? Jerry?
Okay, thanks, Bud. Because I know only you know exactly how I feel about the fact that you possibly are going to be able to stay here in Fernwood and continue as host of the Fernwood Tonight Show.
Well, I hope so.
And it'd be such a tragedy if you had to go back to Miami in handcuffs, possibly even chains, out in those drab prison uniforms, and your good name dragged through the dirt. People referring to you as a criminal gimbal. Just think of the indignities you'd have to suffer in one of those prisons down there in Florida. And plus all the other things. Plus the fact that you'd be replaced on the show as host by someone whose background, as far as scandal is concerned, is Lily White.
Right, okay.
To begin with, Bill Platt, here in our Channel 6 art department and maintenance crew, that's Channel 6. Has come up with a little graph, which, or a little, actually a little, kind of like a, whoa.
Oh, Bill.
I don't know what you call it. Bill didn't oil this, but
no, Bill,
he did a heck of a job.
You made a mistake. Bill Platt is our art department and maintenance staff.
Yeah. And does a great, puts together a great salad in those hot summer months. When
certainly
it's,
does, too.
And he mixes up some iced tea that can't be beat. Anyway, this represents the $3,800 it's going to take to get the Fernwood Tonight furniture
absolutely
out of hock.
Absolutely.
Now, every time, now this is my idea. I'd give it to Bill, but it is my idea. Every time someone phones in a donation or more than one person and they total $10, I'm going to make a little notch down here. And when those notches total $3,800, then I'll fill it all in, scriggle, scraggle. Sorry.
Don't you think it might be a little bit more effective for our viewers if you did something a little bit more dramatic than just like that? I mean, couldn't you color it in as you go?
Well, yeah, but then I'm going to get a chalk dust all over my suit. I mean, the show looks cheesy enough with getting chalk dust all over my cuffs.
If you'd like to come down to the studio and drop off your cash or check with the proper ID, just go right to the M Street entrance. Jerry. Don't believe it.
The nursing.
Oh, boy.
I got him with all four of them.
Well, Jerry, I'm leaving in good hands here. That's good stuff. Remember to help this thing add up, okay? And we're going to be here for 24 hours, okay? Now. There we go. It's cute, Jerry. Here to start the financial ball rolling tonight is the president of Fernwood's Fascinating Female League, Mrs. Candy Lee Hargrove. I never said she was a professional singer or dancer. I said she was a friend that came on the air. It's her own dress, yes. No, she's doing it as a favor. I'm not going to ask her to do that. That's rude. Well, what's it worth to you, huh? $20? Make it $25 and you got a deal. Really? Okay, will do. Okay, bye-bye. Candy, stop. We'll be right back after these words. Jerry?
An omen of evil. She is a demon reincarnated. Together, they unleash total terror in the all-new shocker, The Night Child.
The child must be born.
And the original horror classic, Beyond the Door. The Night Child and Beyond the Door. Twice the terror for those who dare. Rated R.
Now showing at the Woods Theater downtown, last feature midnight every night.
Sessions presents 62 Golden Greats.
Here it's another Saturday night, and I ain't got nobody.
I'm so dizzy, my head is spinning.
62 Golden Greats contains 62 original hits by the original artists, all on four giant stereo LPs. Just listen. Is a sensational treasury of full-length original classics that you're sure to enjoy. This rare collection is not available in any store, so order yours today.
Drop your silver in my tambourine.
This special four-record collector's edition is available right now for only $9.98. Two 8-track or cassette tapes are only $11.98. Here's how to order.
To order COD, call 312-728-3800. Operators are on duty now. That's 728-3800. Save the $2 COD charge. Send check or money order to 62 Golden Greats, Box 6677, Chicago, Illinois, 60680. That's 62 Golden Greats, Box 6677, Chicago, Illinois. Residents, please add state sales tax.
Kill it, Happy. Boy, we don't need calls like that. We need calls with money, okay? This call here was some guy called up. Said he refused to give one penny, one lousy, stinking Kenny to the Fernwood Tonight-a-thon because he said I was guilty of payola and assaulting a cheerleader. This is the kind of thing that makes me maybe think that I should go into turkey farming after all, you know, because even a 20-pound Tom with his head cut off couldn't be suffering from quite so much vacant space on the penthouse level as this turkey on all of it. Let me set the record straight once and for all. Very simply, what happened was this, okay? I was doing a show in Miami called Dade County Merry-Go-Round. My own name, thank you. A young lady appeared on the program one afternoon. She was a cheerleader from a college down there, and they were trying to sell season tickets for the football games. Nice enough thing to do. It was a small college. Their big ambition was to someday have a good enough season to be invited to play in the Astro Blue Bonnet Bowl, which to me always sounds like a place that spacemen keep their margarine, but... You're just trying to keep the tears back. Anyway, the public relations man from the college took the cheerleader and me to lunch after the show. Nothing there. At one point during the lunch, at his suggestion, okay, we went to the men's room together, whereupon he handed me a key to a motel room, winked, and said, and I believe this is an exact quote, okay, he said, "Hey, is that a great-looking set of headlights or what?" Okay. When we arrived at the motel room, there was a bottle of champagne waiting for us, and that's all there was to it. The fact that those newspapers down there would even think of looking for Polaroid pictures in a motel's trash bin, let alone run them on the front page of the Metro section, shows you what I was up against down there. Okay, all right, enough about that. Now, the payola thing. Boy, is it hot in here or is it my career? The payola thing. And before we go on with this, I want to see this phone start ringing, okay? I'm going naked up here, and I don't mean that about the jacket. I need to see some response. All right, I can wait. Is that a ring? No, it wasn't. Okay. Well, we'll just wait. I know you're out there. If I didn't believe that, I'd be too sick to even eat in the morning, right? Five, five, five. 5:16. Okay, it's a half-hour show. We'll go longer. Well, actually, we're on 24 hours a day, so we can just wait this one out. If you need a dime, find someone to give you change. Hello. Okay, great. Jerry, you want to field this one?
All right.
I think we got a hot one.
Hello.
All right, now, the payola thing. I mentioned it. I'll tell you. So-called payola thing. I had mentioned some very fine public-spirited merchants on the air in Miami. They had given me some things that it just didn't seem to me ethically right to accept. So we used the station's parking lot one weekend for a little, and I mean little, flea market-type sale of those gifts. Suddenly, this manic of a station manager calls. He calls the FCC, and they send down an inspector who looks like he exhales what exterminators spray. You know what I mean? Okay. Smells the same way, too. And that was all she wrote, Phil. Now listen.
Excuse me a second, Barth. Do you happen to remember what time Leave It to Beaver is on tonight?
Jerry, will you tell her that we're in the middle of something a little bit more important, huh? And not a rerun?
Will do.
And then hang up. Hang up on it. Okay, thank you. Well, tie it up. Jared, we got two phones.
He said he doesn't know, and he'll get back to you with the answer if he can.
No, I don't have a big speech prepared here. But we are here begging, okay? We're begging. It's too late in the evening for even pride. I've taken my jacket off. The heck with the pride. Now, for a small amount of money, let's, just let our guests sit in comfort and quiet elegance. That's our plan. We want that furniture back. If you never again in your life call a television station to pledge money, what can I possibly say? Make this the time. Stupid spray. And to the neighbor of that 13-year-old girl who started all this, I have only one thing to say. Sir, is that a great-looking set of headlights or what? I'm sorry. I'm just kidding. I'm trying, as I say, to keep from crying. Just please call. That's all I'm asking. Please, please call. We'll be right back. We'll be here during the commercial. Don't hesitate to call us. 555-5624. 555-5624. We'll be right back. Call.
your step with Visa. Take Visa with you wherever you go. It makes family shopping a breeze. It takes you out to dinner with ease. Visa can okay your checks. It lets you travel anywhere you please. Take Visa with you wherever you go.
Visa, for just about everything you do, just about everywhere. From Chicago's Bank, the First National Bank of Chicago.
Here comes the windup, the pitch, and there it goes into left field. Another hit. That's the 39th consecutive game in which he's hit safely, but still far short of the record of 56 set by Joe DiMaggio.
Ever wonder how sportscasters seem to have all the information right at their fingertips? Well, here's the secret. A handy file of these sports cards. They tell you all you need to know about sports. The records, the great games, the stars, the rules, the whole exciting world of sports. There are cards on football, tennis, golf, all sports, even unusual ones like karate and motocross. Cards on the stars, too, like Tom Seaver, Bobby Orr, Johnny Unitas, and many others. On the front of each card, a full-color picture. On the back, dozens of fascinating facts. The records, who broke them, and when. The finer points of famous games, the controversies and strategies. Plus, the athlete's story, how he rose to fame, his achievements and setbacks. Special symbols tell you at a glance the contents of all the cards and let you file them as you wish, by type of sport, by subject matter, or simply alphabetically. It's like a new sports encyclopedia of pictures and facts, only much more fun, much easier to use. It puts you right in the center of the action. But see for yourself. Send for your first set of 24 sports cards with dividers for only $1. You can return the cards in 10 days for your dollar back, or keep them, and then, as long as you like, get a new shipment each month for just $1.89 per set plus shipping. We'll also send you this handsome file case absolutely free, even if you return the cards. And if you act immediately, we'll include an extra set of 24 cards free. Here's all you do.
Order now and you'll get the first set of sports cards plus the second set free and the file case for only $1. Phone 312-275-6800. That's 312-275-6800. Or save COD charges by sending $1 to Sports Cards, Box 6670, Chicago, Illinois, 60602.
Thank you again, sir. It's not money, but it's 400 blue chip stamps. We're something. We're ahead. Okay, well, we've got to get off the air now, but the telethon is going to continue. Just because you can't see it on your television set doesn't mean you shouldn't call up and send in your money, all right? We'll be here for 24 straight hours, singing, dancing, doing everything else we can to please you. Even though you won't be able to see it, the life of Fernwood Tonight is in your hands, okay? This could be our last show. Only you have the power to call your station, please, please, and insist that they keep us on the air past these mega, what's it been, Jerry, like 60, 65 shows, something like that?
Who keeps track? But it has been 65, exactly.
Yeah. It's a drop in the video bucket, and we got support all over the darn country. People from big-time show people. I got a telegram right here.
Yeah,
from one of my favorite performers.
Telegram.
You got some, too?
Yeah.
This is from a guy out in California. He's an actor. He's a singer. He does just about everything. His name is Martin Mull, one of my favorites. Everybody says here, dear Barth, we're feeling for you here. If you lose your job in Fernwood, it's the same as me losing mine here in California. I really don't. What do you got, Jerry?
I've got some telegrams. Here's one from a brilliant young actor out on the coast, Fred Willard. He says that.
One of my favorites.
He just says simply, I'm keeping my fingers crossed, and he adds that he would like to send some money as a donation, but he's working in a syndicated TV show and they don't pay much. And here's one from Robert Goulet.
Woo.
Sent this, and he said, please read this on the air. Let's see. Don't forget, I'll be opening at the Deauville Hotel in Pittsburgh, October 13th through the 18th.
Jerry, what does that have to do with our telegram?
It has nothing whatsoever with us at all.
It's a waste of time.
It certainly is. Waste of time. You mean going to see him?
Maybe that too. That's all the time we have right now.
Sorry,
please, it's 555-5624. Have a heart. See you soon, God willing. Okay, call. Call and send.
Al Alice's good intentions backfire and send husband Jackie Gleason into a jealous rage. And the Honeymooners laugh again next on Channel 32.
Papel as Candy Lee Hargrove.
The most incredible history of World War II ever filmed. Told by those who lived and fought through it, and narrated by Laurence Olivier. The World at War. Sunday night at 6 on Channel 32, WFLD-TV, Chicago.
Jackie Gleason. The Honeymooner.